This is the next version of the BeastBlind Surface Editor work in process. I start here with spline surface with 100 poles, this one. Just this vector array. The next thing what I have is the FreeCAD editor. I can visualize the result of this editor. The surface at the start, it's the same as the starting surface. I hide this starting surface. Next thing what I have is from this result UV grid activate. Oh, I activate the UV grid and I activate the surface. We have this layout and I have here a shape pattern node. I use it to display the position of the cursor on the surface. In this case I use here the tree object. I also can use here a line, but I think the tree is a nice feature of the shape pattern, so I will use it. Okay, now let's start to work. We work with the editor, and first thing what I can do is I can start to move the cursor here on the surface, and I can change one coordinate. I can change the position of the point, and the algorithm now tries to change the surface this way that the foot point of this cursor is always on the surface. So I can do this this way, and I can commit this place, and now I can move to the next position and can now move it up here this way, and I commit it and I go to the next place here, and once more I can go down and I commit it. I can change the shape pattern here to a sphere, and I change the radius of the sphere, so we see this point is always on the surface and the surface is always bended this way. The surface here, I hide the grid, the surface here has still the same number of poles, so I have only a modification of the surface by approximating some of the points. Here we see the track of the work, and we see here we use a SkiPy Optimize Minimum Nelder Mead algorithm. The runtime here is less than 1/10 second. The quality is less than 10 height minus 5, is very exact. In this case, running time is good. So I can do this, and I can change in this way the surface. Of course, it's the movement of this point also influences some of the neighbor poles. So that means when I change this point, then these four points, if these four poles points are moved in such a way that the distance of the surface to this point is a minimum using this function. At the moment, I only use the Nelder-Mead algorithm because it's the fastest and it always gives me a good result. Maybe I later give the possibility, opportunity to use other algorithms too. So I also can now use more extreme heights. That means I can go here with Z this way, and I can use here an extra scalar, and we see here the quality is still good enough, and the running time is also still good enough. I can commit it and can continue my work. But I also can say I want to go back. I have here the rollback function. If I apply rollback, and then in the next step I make an execute, then the original surface is reused, and I have here the next the next way to make a modification.